Hey everyone, ocean conservation and marine life expert Jacqueline Friedlander here, and today we are in Florida at Alexandra Spring and we are going to go on a freshwater scuba dive.
This is a first magnitude spring, which means that it puts out 64 million gallons of freshwater per day.
Let's go exploring and see what we find.
Look at those freshwater bubbles ahead of us. Let's swim closer and see where they're coming from. Bubbles in a spring come from an underground aquifer. Aquifer, a geological formation containing groundwater that supplies the water for wells and springs. This is a spring vent. The volume of the water flowing from a spring is dependent upon a variety of factors. The water pressure in the aquifer beneath it, the number of caves leading up to the spring vent, and the size of the vent itself. As you can see, the water here is flowing upwards very quickly. This water looks clean, but a water quality test would be necessary to see how clean it really is. The water in aquifers that eventually bubbles up like this into the springs can be contaminated by a number of human pollutants in groundwater, such as fertilizers or chemical pesticides. This is a good example of erosion. Erosion, the process of gradual destruction or wearing away by wind, water, or other natural agents. Look, a turtle. This turtle has a bunch of algae on his back. As I was swimming by, he swam down into the vegetation to hide. Even though he's using camouflage to try to hide and be invisible, can you find him? Unlike that turtle who wanted nothing to do with me, I made some fishy friends. I found sand to chill out on, and once these fish realized I wouldn't hurt them, they gathered around, probably to see if I had any food for them. When we arrived at the spring earlier, I noticed this alligator sign. Right as we were swimming to the surface, I heard a noise at the water's edge. Alligator? Nope, two raccoons taking a bath. One scuba dive per day simply isn't enough, so we took a little drive over to Rainbow River. They even let me drive the boat. The main difference between the river and Alexandra Springs, where we just came from, is that since the last dive site is more of a swimming hole, there were less animals hanging out. On this dive, I saw a bunch of freshwater fish. There were some hanging out right under the boat. Rainbow River is fed by Rainbow Springs, also a first magnitude spring, and I found some bubble spots where the water was coming up from the aquifer. If you have questions about freshwater springs or aquifers, leave them in the comments below. See you next Friends with Fins Friday. Thanks for watching.